In Jammu and Kashmir's Baramulla district, terrorist ambush army convoy, three security personnel, which included two army jawans and one cop, were martyred in the attack. Army launches search operation. Army chief to visit Jammu today to review security situation. Four Naxals were killed and a jawan was injured in the encounter with security forces in the forest of Dantewada in Bastar region of Chhattisgarh. Huge cashew farms and ammunitions recovered from the spot. India and Bangladesh agreed to scale up cooperation in information sector. Doordarshan and Bangladesh TV to co-produce documentary on Sheikh Mujibur-Rahman. AIR to launch special channel to showcase Bangla culture and heritage. India closes its embassy in the Yemeni capital Sana'a. External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj informs that the decision has been taken due to continuous strife in the country. A day-long session of Jharkhand Assembly has been convened today to ratify Goods and Services Tax Bill passed by both the Houses of Parliament recently. The GST bill has already been ratified by Assam and Bihar earlier. The government has allowed online authentication using Aadhaar for new mobile connections. The guidelines for Aadhaar, electronic Know Your Customer or the eKYC were issued to make the online process of application and authentication faster and simpler for subscribers. Home Ministry has ordered security audit of nearly 100 civil airports and decided to bring all such facilities under CISF cover gradually. It has also planned random checking of incoming air travellers at the entrance of airports. Home Ministry has also decided to extend the CISF cover to Srinagar and Imphal airports. Till now, CRPF had been providing security at these two airports. Information and Broadcasting Minister Venkaiah Naidu appealed to the political parties to speak in one voice on the issues of Balochistan and Gilgit. He said everyone should avoid making any statement which hurts the country's interests. Naidu said it is unfortunate that the main opposition party Congress is not speaking in one voice. A mysterious British-era 150 metres long, 3 metres wide and around 12 feet high tunnel has been discovered beneath Raj Bhavan in Mumbai. The bunker is spread over an area of 5,000 square feet. The tunnel has several spaces created on its both sides to store arms and ammunition. It also has rooms for people to live. An Indian-American has been appointed as one of the four co-chairs to the Democratic presidential candidate Hillary Clinton's campaign transition project. The Clinton-Kane transition project, headed by former Interior Secretary Ken Salazar, has been tasked to ensure smooth transition of power, including identifying key senior positions in the new administration if Clinton and her running mate Tim Kaine win the 8 November general elections. Russian warplanes flew out of an Iranian airbase for the first time to bomb jihadist groups in Syria as fighting raged for control of the ravaged city of Aleppo. The defense ministry in Moscow said long-range warplanes took off from Hamadan base in western Iran and conducted a group airstrike against targets of the IS. Death toll from historic flooding in the U.S. state of Louisiana has gone up to 8 as the expanding flood zone prompted authorities to declare disasters in a dozen parishes. 40,000 homes have been impacted by the floods and more than 8,000 people were in shelters. Shuttler PV Sindhu has raised hopes of breaking India's long-awaited medal quest in Rio Olympics by storming into the semi-finals of the women's singles event with a stunning straight games win over London Games silver medalist Wang Yihan of China at Rio. Sindhu, who came into the match with a 2-4 head-to-head record, dished out a compact game to outmaneuver the most experienced Wang 22-20, 21-19 in a grueling battle lasting 54 minutes. Indian wrestler Narsingh Yadav's Olympic campaign hit a massive roadblock after the World Anti-Doping Agency decided to appeal against the clean sheet given to him by NADA in a dope scandal back home. The hearing in this case will take place on 18th of August. Narsingh had tested positive for a banned anabolic steroid in tests conducted on June 25th. US star Simone Biles got the golden finale she craved for in Rio with a fourth women's crown, but former gymnastics power China led the games without a title for the first time in 32 years. The 19-year-old Biles wrapped up 10 days of incredible gymnastics with a trademark dominant display of acrobatics and tumbling on the floor in the Rio Olympic arena.